20, verse 17 to 19. And then we're reading Isaiah 37, verse 24 to 29. So Matthew 20, verse 17 to verse 19. And then Isaiah 37, from 24 to 29.
Matthew 20, verse 17, the Bible says, "Now Jesus, going up to Jerusalem, took the 12 disciples aside on the road and said to them, 'Behold, we are going up to Jerusalem, and the Son of Man will be betrayed to the chief priest and to the scribes, and they will condemn him to death.'" Verse 19, "And deliver him to the Gentiles to mock and to scourge and to crucify."
And they will deliver him to the Gentiles to mock, to scourge, and to crucify.
"And the third day it will rise again. Greatness is serving."
Glory to God. Amen.
Amen.
Isaiah 37, 24 to 29.
Isaiah 37, 24. The Bible says,
"Yes.
By your servants you have reproached the Lord and said, 'By the multitude of my chariots, I have come up to the height of the mountains.'"
Please, can you take that again?
"By your servants you have reproached the Lord."
God is prophesying through the prophet Isaiah. I want you to understand as she reads, and prophet Isaiah is speaking differently. There's a time he will be speaking as God, and there's a time he will be speaking as the people of Assyria. Amen.
Amen.
Because God is speaking to the enemies of Israel at that time, who was the people of Assyria. Amen.
Amen.
I pray that God may speak to your enemies today.
Amen.
And all throughout this month.
Amen.
There's a time for you to pray, but there's a time where God himself addresses words to your enemies.
Amen.
And so God is telling the Assyrians and the Assyrian king that you, what does he say?
By your servants you have reproached the Lord and said, "By the multitude of my carriers, I have come up to the height of the mountains."
So the Assyrians said that by the multitude of their chariots, they have been able to ascend up to the mountains.
Mm-hmm. "To the limit of Lebanon, I will cut down its tall cedars and its choice cypress trees. I will enter its height to its fruitful forest." Mm. Verse 25, "I have dug and drunk water with the soles of my feet. I have dried up all the brooks of defense."
I've drunk all the water, and with the soles of my feet, I dried up every brook or every source of water that Israel had. Amen.
Amen.
Other versions say, "I dried up all the sources of water in Egypt." So you must understand that the Assyrians were very boastful people. Amen.
Amen.
I don't know if you are dealing with boastful enemies in your life. I don't know if you are dealing with boastful people, boastful mockers in your life. But here, God is speaking to a people that not only was mocking Israel, but was boasting in themselves. Are you with me?
Amen.
And they were saying that with my feet, the Assyrians, they were able to dry up rivers. In other words, they were blessed more than other people. They had the cedars of Lebanon. They had chariots and horses. They were able to ascend like in mountains and take control of cedar trees. If you know the Bible, you know that the trees of cedar are very special trees. Amen?
Amen.
Up until today, on the flag of Lebanon, there's the tree of the cedar of Lebanon, which is a very special type of wood. Continue.
Verse 26, the Bible says, "Did you not hear long ago?"
Now God is speaking now. Now he's not talking as they talked. He's talking as himself, God. And he says, "Did you not hear long ago
how I made it from ancient times that I formed it?"
From ancient times I formed it. In French it says, "N'avez-vous pas entendu que depuis les temps anciens j'ai formé cette chose? Et depuis l'éternité je l'ai établi." Continue.
"Now I have brought it to pass."
And now, me, God, I've allowed this thing to happen. What does he allow? Listen to it.
"That you should be for crushing fortified cities."
That you should be crushing. That you should be destroying fortified
cities.
So it was in the allowance of God that the Assyrians were not only mocking the people of God, But they were able to destroy cities. Not any type of cities, but 45. Are you in the year of 45 cities with me?
Yes.
Now continue, please.
That you should be for crushing 45 cities into the heaps of ruins. 27. Therefore, their inhabitants had little power.
Therefore, the inhabitants of those fortified cities, they had little power.
They were dismayed and confounded.
They were confused, dismayed, bewildered. Continue.
They were as the grass of the field and the green herb, as the grass on the housetops and great blighted before it is grown.
Yes.
28.
28.
But I know your dwelling place.
Now God says, but I know your dwelling place. Who? Assyria. Listen to me. You may not know your enemy. You may not know your mockers very well.
Come on.
But God knows their dwelling place. Listen, you are a child of God.
Amen.
Your defense is his responsibility. Where your pastor cannot take your defense, God will always do it.
Amen.
Where your biological parents might not take your defense, God will always do it.
Amen.
There was a time when Jesus went to pray and he asked the disciples to come so they can take his defense. The Bible says they slept when he was praying. Sometimes people will sleep on you, but God does not sleep on his people. The Bible says in Psalms 121, voici il ne sommeille. Oh, shakala. He does not sleep. No slumber, he who guards Israel. Someone say, God,
God,
thank you for protecting me.
Thank you for protecting
me. Say it again, God,
God,
thank you for standing for me.
Thank you for standing.
God
for
tells
me.
The enemies of these people, I know
your dwelling place.
Continue.
But I know your dwelling place.
Yes.
You're going out and you're coming in.
You're going out and you're coming in.
And your rage against me.
And I know your anger or your words against me.
29. Because you rage against me.
Because you have waged against me.
And your tumult have come up to my ears.
And your what?
Tumult.
Okay, that's what it says in your version. Your tumult have come up into my ears.
My ears. Therefore, I will put my hook in your nose.
I will put my hook in the nose of the Assyrians. Continue.
And my brother in your lips. And I will turn you back by the way you which you came.
And I will turn you back. By the way from
which you came.
You came. May the Lord turn your enemies back. The Bible says in the new covenant that they will come from one way. And they shall return in seven different directions.
Amen.
I stand as a prophet in this house and on this pulpit. And under the integrity of the word of God, I declare that ways are being opened in your life right now. So that the demons, the spirits, the words, the enemies, the mockers that have stood against you may find a way to leave. May God give you deliverance that is spectacular. I repeat again, que Dieu te donne une délivrance spectaculaire. The Bible says when the lepers were walking to go and take food, their feet sound was like that of a great army. Diminue un peu le volume. I pray that God may give you attention from people. The people may see when he blesses you. Oh, je répète encore que les hommes voient quand Dieu te bénit. Jesus did not disappear into heaven. He rose for everyone to see. He rose that the people that believed could see. I pray that God may allow you to rise. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. You may have your seat as I finish my message. May God bless you. Hallelujah. All I want to do is pray. As I was saying yesterday, mockery marks a crucial moment in the life of a child of God. Amen. Hallelujah. The day you see people mocking you, the season you start feeling mockery to your ears, know that at that time you have entered a crucial moment of your destiny. Amen. Now this is the month of the crucial blessing. But there is no crucial blessing without a crucial moment.
Come on.
Are you with me?
Amen.
When God said, let us create man and woman, it was a crucial moment that birthed a crucial blessing. On est ensemble.
Amen.
Frère, ne négligez ne néglige pas les moments cruciaux et critiques de ta vie. I repeat it because I know where we are going, some of us.
Come on, come on.
Never depend on people in your family to pray. Never depend on your friends to fast. Never depend on your loved ones to build altars. Because when you descend in your grave, even if you die, four of you at the same time, each person has his own coffin. Did you see a bulk coffin? Huh?
No.
Unless they just throw you all in the Holocaust in the cemetery, they just throw you all. You die yourself. When you be standing in front of God, you face God yourself. Amen.
Amen.
We can all cry together, but my tears are my own now. We can all lose someone. We are all crying, but my pain is my pain. Do you hear me? Now, crucial moments are for you first.
Come on.
And if you are depending on the movement of Africa to understand that a revival is coming, you will lose it. Je parle à quelqu'un. If you are depending on the movement of the human race, you might think Jesus is not coming now. Are we together?
Come on.
It is your spiritual sensitivity that will allow you to encounter the crucial blessing, crucial moment. Are we together? And I told you as I began that one of the first things, or one of the first moments that I want to talk about is moments of mockery. Now, maybe you are not being mocked as an individual. Maybe you are being mocked as a collective. Maybe they're not mocking you. They are mocking me, prick. On your ensemble.
Yes.
They're not mocking you, but they're mocking your family. They're mocking your country. Hallelujah. Now, when people have given their lives to God, when people have put their faith in God, I told you yesterday, mockery becomes a perfume to God. It can cause God to move in your favor. Amen.
Amen.
Now, what we have read here will allow us to finish with this first crucial moment. I told you Jesus in Matthew tells his disciples, let's go to Jerusalem and let me tell you what's going to happen. First, I will be judged and I will be condemned to death. Later, I will be crucified. But in between my judgment and my crucifixion, I must pass dans la parfumerie du ciel.
Come on.
I must pass a season that will allow for my sacrifice to be valid. Frère, il n'y a pas de sacrifice valide sans moquerie.
Come on, come on.
The Bible says, for the preaching of the gospel is a folly. It is madness to people that do not believe. Now, if you are talking madness, do you think people will mock you? Therefore, the people who believe in the gospel are destined to mockery. Look at your neighbor and say, we are destined.
We are destined.
For mockery.
For mockery.
But also for greatness.
But also for greatness.
Please, encourage somebody else. Prophet, we are destined.
We are destined.
For mockery.
For mockery.
But also for greatness.
But also for greatness.
Christians who complain about mockery are not spiritual.
Come on.
Christians who complain about mockery are not mature. They want it easy. Jesus says, if they hated me, they will, not they might. They will hate you. There are categories of people in your life that have been placed there simply to perfume you with mockery. Because if you don't pass by mockery, there is a glorification that you will not know. On your song.
Yes.
Sometimes they mock your church. Sometimes they mock the body of Christ. You sit in a place and you hear people talking and saying, les chrétiens ne sont pas sérieux. Les chrétiens sont pauvres. Les chrétiens sont pas intelligents. These things must boost you to prayer. Someone say, I press on.
I press on.
Come on, this is a prophetic service. Say, I press on.
I press on.
Press on when you are being mocked. I told you some people can have comments that are mockeries. Today we have gone even to a very greater level of mockery. There are memes for you. Send you a meme. about your financial situation. Amen. You laugh, but your heart is hurting because you know it's you, bro. Amen.
Come on.
Mockeries determine certain moments. Are we together?
Yes.
The Bible speaks in the book of 2 John, if I'm not mistaken, of a woman. Some of her children gave their lives to Jesus, others didn't. And Apostle John is writing to that woman and he says, to Kyria, who has a house in her a church in her house, and certain sons have given their life to Christ, and he begins to speak to her about love. It's the Gospel of John. Obviously, the epistles of John are epistles of love. And he tells her, walk in love and let your son see love. Because she was enduring mockery at that time. You see, when Jesus rose, it was recounted, it was said that he did not rise. It was said that they stole his body and hid it somewhere. So not everyone was celebrating at the resurrection of Jesus. Some people were laughing. Amen.
Come on.
The mocking of the Gentiles preceded the coming of the Holy Ghost.
Come on.
Mockery precedes elevation.
Amen.
Mockery precedes visitations. Or can I talk to somebody?
Come on.
You sit in a house and you feel like your aunt or your uncle or your cousin is not taking you seriously in whatever you're doing, your business, and they just say, you know what, just go and be a security. I can't anymore. See, till when? God, you are busy complaining. Press on in prayer.
Come on.
The attitude of a spiritual man in crucial moments of mockery is prayer.
Amen.
It's faith. Amen.
Amen.
Do you know what Abraham means? Abraham means father of nations. And God gave it to a man who had no child.
Come on, come on.
Said, from now on you'll be called Abraham. Can you imagine the level of mockery he had to endure? Every time they asked him, what is your name? He said, I'm a father of nations. Ah, frère. Soyez un peu sérieux quand même. S'il vous plaît. What is your name? My name is Prophet Trésor. What do you mean you're a prophet?
Come on.
What is your name? My name is a millionaire. Ah! Sister. So humble. They even start saying you be
humble.
Why? Because you do not look like what God told you you are.
Come on.
Just imagine Gideon goes to people and says, yeah, d'ailleurs même il m'a appelé vaillant héros. What do you mean? Are you with me?
Yes.
The name that Abraham had to assume, it was to bring about mockery. Because God knew, before I open the womb of Sarah,
come on.
People must perfume this couple.
Yes.
Some people must mock.
Come on.
Do not expect to go higher passing through mockery. If you are not ready to be mocked, you're not ready to be rich.
Come on.
Oh, if you're not ready to be mocked, you're not ready to be elevated. You're not ready to be éclairé. You're not ready to be seen in the things of God. Are you with me?
Yes.
Do you think everyone celebrated Paul when he converted to Christianity? He was against it. On ensemble, he was against Christianity. And he was one of the leaders. He had letters that were giving him authority to destroy churches. Do you understand le niveau d'abord que Paul avait? Now that man begins to defend that which he condemned. See, some people here are called to walk in miracles, but you are scared to be mocked.
Come on.
Yeah, because you spoke against prophets, spoke against apostles when they made miracles. Now God is telling you, toi aussi tu vas faire sortir l'huile dans les mains des gens. Hey! Now you're quiet. Because you don't want people to mock you because you did not believe and you must now believe. Are we together?
Amen.
Mockery releases miracles.
Amen.
Mockery provokes God. Can I go deeper? Please be with me
come
as I speak.
On, come on.
You know, there was a time when someone mocked God and God performed a miracle for them. Can I go in the Bible?
Come on.
Genesis. Bible says God came as three men to Abraham. Abraham gave the three men things to eat. Then the three men asked Abraham, where is your wife, Sarah? Abraham says, she's in the tent right there. And then the three men begin to declare, at this same day, next year, this woman will have a child. The Bible says, Sarah mocked God.
Come on.
And the Bible says, the three men asked Sarah, why are you laughing? She came out of the tent and she said, I did not laugh. You know how that chapter ends? The chapter ends by God saying, yes, you mocked me. Go read the Bible. See the dernier verse. But in the next chapter, we see God in the same time next year giving her a child. Why? The mockery of Sarah to God provoked a miracle from God to Sarah. Now, am I telling you to mock God? No, I'm not telling you to mock God. I am showing you how prophetically mockery has been used before miracles. I announce in the name of Jesus and in the atmosphere of the prophetic, anyone under the sound of my voice that has been enduring mockery will be enjoying elevation. I repeat it again, my God. Anyone under the sound of my voice that has been enduring mockery will enjoy elevation,
Jesus,
will enjoy blessings,
Jesus,
will enjoy visitation,
Jesus,
in the same place where they have been mocked.
Amen.
The Bible says, Sarah, that is why Isaac means laughter. Isaac est la preuve de la moquerie qui a précédé le miracle. And Jesus is the image of Isaac. Sorry, Isaac is the image of Jesus. Amen. Jesus is now the real Isaac. Now the old Isaac had to be sacrificed on a mountain. But he came out of laughter. He is the fruit of laughter. If the life of Isaac is the result of laughter, the resurrection of Jesus is a result of laughter. If the life of Isaac is a result of laughter, the death of Jesus and his resurrection came by the perfume of laughter. Mary is a perfume. On our song.
Talk to us.
I told you yesterday, now we are getting spiritual. Sometimes you go in places and they give prayer points and you don't know what to pray anymore. Just tell God, Lord, smell the mockery around me.
Come on.
You read the book of Psalms. David keeps saying, jusqu'à quand vais-je être le sujet des moqueries des autres? Up until when will people laugh at me? Why did David experience so much glory? Because he knew what moves God. He knew that when they mock me, I must not shut them up. I must just open God's mouth.
Amen.
Some people will not stop mocking you. It is with a purpose. Are you with me? I pray that in this house people may become more spiritual.
Amen.
I pray that you may educate other
Amen.
Christians from now on.
Amen.
Not to complain when people are mocking
Come
them,
on.
But to have faith and to press on in faith.
Jesus' name. Amen.
Now the Bible says the Assyrians were mocking Israel. On top of mocking them, they were mistreating them. Amen. And as they were treating them that way, God was listening. Écoute, même quand tu dors, Dieu entend les échos des moqueries quand on a été vers toi. And the Bible says, if you read the story, it is King Ezekiah that is complaining. And he says, what are we going to do now? What will God do for us with these Assyrians? Because they want to kill us. And God takes a prophet, opens the mouth of Isaiah, and Isaiah begins to prophesy.
Come on.
And he says this, I have heard me, God. What Assyrians are saying. They said we are great. Take our chariots and we go to the highest level of mountains. We have the greatest trees. With our feet we have dried up rivers. They have reproached God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When a person challenges your life and your life is attached to the tree of life, they have challenged the tree.
Come on.
And there's a thing about trees. Je parle comme prophète. trees outlive humans. Do you know that? Les arbres vivent plus longtemps que les humains. There are trees that have seen your grandfather and his grandfather. Je parle comme prophète, je peux enseigner.
Talk to us, come on.
Trees outlive who? Humans. Now when a person challenges my life or mocks me, they are mocking the tree of life. For the Bible says in Romans, you have been griefed, you have been linked. Vous avez été greffé à un arbre. Jesus says, John 15:15, I am the vine and you are the branches. We are part of a tree. You cannot mock the tree of life and retain life.
Come on.
Because there is a day when the tree met a tree.
Talk to us, come on.
And he told that tree, give me fruits. Pourquoi Jésus peut maudire le figuier? Parce que c'est une affaire d'arbre. Tells the fig tree, now that you have not fed me, you will not be attached to my blessing. I am a tree of life. You will die. The Bible says they went as they came back, that tree died. I declare and decree, any person contending and mocking you, any person mocking the church, any person mocking your ministry, any person mocking your family, any person mocking the people in your family that believe in Jesus, they will meet the tree of life. They will meet the tree of life. If what they are doing cannot give Jesus a fruit that he wants, they will wither. I say they will dry up. I say they will dry up. I repeat again, they will dry up. The Bible says, blessed are those who trust in Jesus, who trust in God, because they are like a tree planted by a river. They give fruit in all seasons. I declare and decree, as they mock you, you keep producing. As they mock you, you keep producing. As they mock you, you keep going higher. Your prayer life will not die. Your blessing will not evaporate. Your faith will not wither. You continue rising, whether you are being mocked or not. I declare and decree, if Sarah had to mock God for a miracle to come out of her, may people's mockeries provoke a miracle from you.
Amen.
Je déclare, les gens qui se sont moqués de toi vont voir ton Isaac,
Jesus,
et la maternité que tu auras.
Donne-moi
un amen meilleur.
Amen. Amen.
Why does God take so long to bless Penina? To bless Anne, sorry. Penina's laughing at her. The Bible says, for years and years, Elkanah cannot do what God can do. Men cannot do what God can do. Elkanah was telling Penina to keep quiet. God did not tell her to keep quiet. He needed the mockeries,
come on,
to perform a miracle. Are you with me? There are times when God will allow. He will allow it. That's what the Bible says. God says, I, did you not hear that I prepared it from times before?
Come on.
I had allowed for it to happen, that you may tamper with the fortified city. C'est compliqué ce que Dieu dit. Because a fortified city, in natural sense, is a city that has layers of protection. Are we in the year of fortified cities? Can you wave your hand and say, God,
God,
fortify my life.
Fortify my,
fortify my cities.
Fortify my,
my health.
Fortify
my prayer.
Fortify
my spirit.
Fortify my,
my marriage.
Fortify my
Everything that I am doing.
Fortify everything that I'm doing.
A fortified city has layers. Are you with me?
Amen.
So there is a gate, but when you enter and you think you can now kill people, there is another wall. You finish that wall, there is another wall. En Allemagne et en, comment on appelle le pays de Galles, Wales, cities used to have mazes. Have you ever watched this movie, The Maze Runner? Bon, ouais. It's a maze, comment on appelle, un labyrinthe. And they had labyrinths in front or around the city. So when the enemy comes in, by the time he gets inside, he's tired or he'll never get there.
Come on.
And if ever he does, the people in the city are very much ready, because you cannot just enter directly in the city. It is fortified. Amen.
Amen.
Fortified cities have what we call watchmen. You know what Habakkuk says? Habakkuk was not just a prophet, he was a watchman. C'était un security. Oh. He used to stand by the walls of the town And he says, I will stand in my post and I will watch. He simply took, Ariel, stop it. He simply took his word and put it into the context of the prophetic. But he was a watchman. Those cities had people that would watch. Quand l'ennemi vient déjà de loin, on envoie des troupes, on se prépare. Do you understand me?
Amen.
Fortified cities had different types and ranks of soldiers. They had all sorts of things. And when you went to Egypt, they did not just have soldiers. They had witchcraft. That's why the king had Chaldeans. And he had eunuchs from Ethiopia. They would come with magic, divination, to help the king protect the town. So when we talk about an Israelite or a Hebrew fortified city, it means they had armies. Hello?
Come on, talk to us.
You read the Bible, you read about les Ephraimites, people from Ephraim and the Benjamites. They were left-handed, the Benjamites. Ils étaient pas gauche, droite, ils étaient quoi?
Gauche.
And they would pull, I have to pull like this, they would pull stones and they would never miss their mark. You understand me? Go read the Bible, you see. So the Benjamites were amongst the greatest warriors of Israel. And apart from armies and soldiers, then they had allies. If they entered into covenant with the Moabites, the Moabites would protect them. If they entered into covenant with the Philistines would protect them. On top of that, they had God.
Come on.
Say with the fortified city.
Fortified city.
They had God. Elohim, El Olam, El Gibor, El Sabaoth, the chief of all armies, the Lord of hosts. Yet God is saying, I allowed you to come and destroy a fortified city. You see, Job was a fortified city. Job did not sin. He was holy.
Come on.
Job never did anything to deserve what he had. But God allowed, the devil came and he said, God said, did you see Job? And the devil said, allow me to touch him. May God protect you now.
Amen.
In Jesus Christ, may you be protected.
Amen.
In Jesus, may you be protected.
Amen. Amen.
So God says, go and touch him, but don't touch his life. He was a fortified city that God allowed to be shaken for a while. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Some people mocking you, they are not mocking you by their own inspiration.
Come on.
They are divinely inspired, yet carnally they are blinded. Quand les gens voulaient crucifier Jésus, ils ne savaient pas qu'il rendait service à l'humanité. Listen, anyone under the sound of my voice who is a victim of mockeries, let this crucial moment birth a crucial blessing for you.
In Jesus' name.
Or not any type of blessing, a crucial blessing.
Amen.
The Bible says in the book of James chapter 1 verse 14 and 13, blessed are those who go through temptations and trials with faith, for they shall receive a crown.
Amen.
We all go to heaven, but not all of us have the same crowns. May God give you a reward, not only on earth. I pray that it may be done as you enter heaven.
Amen.
Say amen if you believe.
Amen.
So, Job, a fortified city, loses his children, loses his money, loses his people, loses everything except for who? A mocking wife. Posez-vous la question. Pourquoi Job perd tout le monde sauf sa femme? Parce que les moqueries sont un parfum pour l'Éternel.
Come on.
Il savait que peut-être les enfants vont intercéder pour Job. Hein? Peut-être que les autres et les travailleurs et tout, ils vont intercéder pour Job. Mais sa femme a la sémence de la moquerie. C'est comme ça que tout le monde meurt, mais elle est protégée avec un but. Il y a de ses ennemis qui sont protégés pas parce que Dieu veut qu'ils soient élevés. Non, ils sont simplement protégés parce qu'ils ont un rôle à jouer dans ta vie. On dit avec moi,
les moqueries
vont relâcher la main de Dieu.
Relâcher la main de Dieu. Amen.
C'est comme ça que Dieu préserve la femme de Job. Et c'est elle qui devient le CD, la musique USB, Zobetara, musique. Et un pot naé, moi siné.
Come on.
Maudit Dieu et meurt. Regarde. Look, if God has preserved a Job's wife in your life, may she do her job.
Amen. Come
and
on.
May you be elevated in
Amen.
Front of her.
Amen.
So a fortified city is destroyed, but a mocker was there. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And in the case of Israel and the Assyrians, God says, I allowed for them to shake this fortified city. Now you might be telling me, prophetess, we've been praying since the beginning of the year. I've been building my fortified city, but look now, this didn't work and that didn't work. Are you sure God gave you this theme for this year? Was it not maybe a year of patience? Frère, it is the year of fortified cities. And if someone is playing with your fortified city, be assured, any mockery around you, it's only for your better.
Amen.
It's only for your good.
Jesus.
You can tell me, prophetess, at the beginning of the year, you told me build an altar, I built. You told me fast, I fasted. You told me pray, I prayed. You said press on, I'm pressing on. But why is my city shaken? God allowed it for a moment. God allowed it for a moment. Then he says this, and I finish here. God says, I allowed you to shake that fortified city. And the inhabitants were weak. They were feeble. They could not defend themselves. And you boasted in yourself, thinking you are the one. There are people who think they make you because it looks like they do.
Come on.
They pay for your school fees. They pay for your house. So they treat you any type of way. But I've come to tell someone something. Là où les païens puissent, c'est toujours la poche de Dieu.
Come on, come on.
C'est eux qui ne le savent pas, c'est toujours la poche de Dieu. Wherever a pagan takes something, it's still the pocket of God. Listen to me. Where a witch takes the breath of life, it's still in the pocket of God.
Come on.
He might think it is witchcraft giving him life, it is still God. The day God shuts the door of life, a witch will die.
Come on.
Are you with me?
Talk to us.
And so God says, you boasted, but now I will stand. He says, and as I stand, I will put my hook in your nose. Why not in your head? Why not in your hands? Why in your nose? Because mockery is a perfume. It has to do with the sense of smell. And because you have lifted mockery against my people, I will pull you by the organ that you provoked me in.
Come on.
Je déclare et je décrète.
Jesus.
In the same place they insulted God. Where they said it was weak, it shall become strong. Where they said you were poor, you shall become rich.
Jesus name.
Where they said you are fallen, you shall rise.
Jesus name.
Where they said you are good for nothing, you shall be good for more than one thing. I declare and decree, from the same way that they provoke God's nose, they will be pulled by the nose. God said, I will put my hook in your nose because I smelt your mockery. You will smell my anger.
Amen.
I declare and decree as I close. May God allow every crucial moment of mockery to lift you up and put other people
Jesus
down.
Name.
La Bible déclare, il renverse et il établit les rois. There are kings that go up because of God. And there are people that go down because of God. You might be a Job today. Your fortified city has been touched. But be assured, tomorrow the glory of the second house
Amen.
Shall be much greater,
in Jesus name.
Much stronger,
in Jesus
much
name.
Beautiful
in Jesus
than the glory
name.
Of the first house.
Amen.
Jesus says, I must be mocked. That when I go and present my life to God, it was not an easy death. I have the perfume of mockery on my sacrifice. Lift up, come stand up and lift your hands and tell God, say, God, smell the mockery in my face. Because I believe in you, some people mock me.
Some people mock
me. Say it, because I serve you.
Because I serve you.
Some people mock me.
Some people mock me.
Because I refuse to go in the ways of the world.
Because I refuse to go in the ways of the world.
Some people mock me.
Some people mock me.
Because I love you.
Because I love you.
Some people mock me.
Some people mock me.
When I pray in tongues.
When I pray in tongues.
Some people mock me.
Some people mock me.
I prophesy.
When I prophesy.
Some people mock me.
Some people mock me.
When I build my altar.
When I build my altar.
People are mocking me.
People are mocking me.
Smell the mockery.
Smell the mockery.
And stand for my case.
And stand for my case.
Let me not miss.
Let me not miss.
The crucial blessing.
The crucial blessing.
In this crucial moment.
In this crucial moment.
Lift your voice and begin to cry to your Father. Cry to your Father. Cry to your Father. Cry to your Father. Cry to your Father.
Hear the mockeries, O Father. In the name of Jesus.
All
the mockeries that are happening around me.
Cry to your Father.
In the name of Jesus.
Cry to your Father.